guys, I'm Hannah, and I am so glad you're here with me today as we start our new series on Easter. We're going to look at some of the events that led up to Jesus's death and resurrection and why it's so important that we celebrate and remember what he did for us. We're going to start off by learning a new memory verse, and that's going to be 1 Corinthians 15:3 through 4. And that says, Christ died for our sins, just as the scriptures say. He was buried and was raised on the third day, just as the scripture says. Now we're going to sing a song together. Here we go. We will sing this verse each week as we go through this series, and you can work on it at home with your family during the week. This verse reminds us exactly what we're celebrating at Easter, Jesus's death and resurrection. Now we're going to watch this week's Bible story, the triumphal entry.
Stories of the Bible, the triumphal entry. This is Jesus.
Hey-o!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like calming storms and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
At this time, the Jewish people were celebrating a festival called Passover that had been celebrated since the time of Moses, when God brought his people out of Egypt. So Jesus was going to Jerusalem to celebrate. Jesus and his disciples stopped in a town.
You coming?
And Jesus told two of his disciples to go on ahead of them.
Okay.
He told them to go into a village and that they would see a young donkey that no one had ever ridden.
Rock!
He told them to untie it and bring it to him. If anyone asks, what are you doing? He told them to just say, the Lord needs it and will return it soon.
Okay, go ahead.
So the disciples did what Jesus said and brought him the donkey. A long time ago, before Jesus was even born, God had said that the Savior, the King of Israel, would come to Israel in this way. And now Jesus was doing just as God had said. The news that Jesus was coming to Jerusalem swept through the city. Many heard about all the amazing things he had done, so they cut palm branches and ran to see him.
Huh?
The Pharisees and religious rulers realized that there was nothing they could do, for everyone was going to see Jesus. Jesus rode into the city of Jerusalem, and the crowd spread their coats on the road ahead of him. His followers began to shout and sing as they walked along, praising God for all the wonderful miracles they had seen. The Pharisees were upset.
Hey, Jesus!
And they told Jesus to stop the people from saying things like that. But Jesus said, if they keep quiet, the stones along the road would burst into cheers. So the people kept on singing, blessings on the King who comes in the name of the Lord. Praise God in highest heaven. The entire city of Jerusalem was in an uproar as he entered, asking, who is this? And the crowds replied, it's Jesus. And Jesus rode the donkey through the street of Jerusalem to the temple in a triumphal entry, just as God said he would many years before.
Now, we are going to hear more about our Bible story and have some fun with our friend Scott, the magician.
Scott the Magician, Apprentice Auditions, take one.
Ow!
Hey everyone, welcome to Scott the Magician's Apprentice Auditions. I'm Scott the Magician, and this is my apprentice, Kylie, who's auditioning today. My last apprentice was shrunk down to the size of a turtle, and I haven't been able to restore him to his proper size yet. But Kylie is here, and she's auditioning. Kylie, how's it going?
This is so amazing. I can't believe I'm actually here right next to Scott the Magician. I feel like I'm dreaming.
Spectacular. And the answer to your question is yes, you really are standing next to me. Today, you're going to be my assistant and help me with some magic tricks.
But remember, as mind-boggling and amazing as these are, they're just tricks.
They aren't real. Are you okay?
Yes, Scott the Magician, can you sign my limited edition Scott the Magician t-shirt?
Maybe a little bit later, but first we need to make magic happen, okay? Let's do this. Okay, for my first act, I'm gonna make the playing card disappear.
Scott the Magician.
Yes, Kylie?
I have an idea for your trick. Since you're the world's greatest magician, how about I get you your very own red carpet? You know, so you can walk on it.
Thank you. But you know, Kylie, this is a little hard to walk on, considering it's the size of my shoe.
Sorry, that was the biggest red carpet I could find. They're actually harder to find than you would think.
That's right. I think I can adjust my trick. Check this out. Watch closely. It goes into my hand, and I ask everyone to say the magic words. Say the magic words.
The magic words.
Perfect. It's gone.
That was amazing. Can you teach me how to do it?
Well, sure, it's easy. All you have to do is take your hat off.
What? How'd you get it under there? I didn't even feel it.
Exactly, that's why it's called magic. Now it's time for a little segment I like to call Super Cool Awesome Magic Stuff. Check this out.
Super Cool Awesome Magic Stuff!
Are you ready?
Yeah.
Check this out.
Whoa.
Yeah, and guess what? You get to keep that. Imaginarily.
That's so cool.
It's back here.
How'd you do that?
Never mind. Yeah. Yeah, you can. Never mind.
Super cool, awesome magic stuff!
You know, looking at this red carpet reminds me of the story of Jesus riding into Jerusalem on a donkey.
I don't get it. Was there a red carpet there?
No, they didn't have red carpets, but they used what they had to honor Jesus. They laid down their coats for Jesus and waved palm branches in the air.
Why did they do that?
Well, they wanted to show Jesus that they loved him. They worshiped him with what they had.
and we can do the same thing.
I remember that story, but in the Bible it says that Jesus was crying. Why was he crying if everyone was showing him that they loved him?
Well, Jesus cried because the people were not aware of his true mission. They rejected the peace that he was offering. You see, Jesus knew that for some of these people, their shouts of praise would soon change to cries for his crucifixion.
Wow, that's awful.
But the thing about Jesus is that he loves us so much that nothing would stop him from fulfilling his mission to save us. And he deserves our praise and our worship, not only for what he's done for us, but for who he is, our Savior, our King of Kings, our Lord of Lords.
Man, I didn't realize that Jesus went through so much. How can I show him that I love him and that I'm thankful for all he did?
Well, you can show Jesus how much you love him by worshiping him. To do that, you can sing, you can dance, you can tell Jesus how much you love him, and you can be thankful for who he is in prayer. There are lots of ways you can worship Jesus, and you should worship Jesus because he's our Savior.
Got it, I could do that.
Well, now I want to show you a cool magic trick with this coat. Check this out. Watch closely.
That's crazy, where'd your leg go?
Oh, it gets better.
Wait, where'd your other leg go?
Oh, wait, it's, here's the real trick.
Okay, that was the coolest magic trick I've probably ever seen. How'd you do that? Please tell me, I'm your magician's assistant.
Okay, I'll show you, but first, I want to remind all of you to remember that this Easter on Palm Sunday, we celebrate Jesus' triumphal entry into Jerusalem. We worship and sing praise to him because of who he is, our Savior. Kylie, I think the audition is over. What do you think?
It was amazing. My favorite part by far was when you made both your legs disappear. That literally blew my mind. Can you sign my shirt now?
Okay. Thanks for tuning into Scott the Magician's Apprentice Auditions. We'll see you guys back here next week.
Wow, Scott showed us some really fun magic tricks. Now remember, magic tricks are just tricks. They're not real. I love what Scott said about how nothing would stop Jesus from going to the cross for our sins. That's how much he loves us. Now this week, we are gonna watch a second Bible story that happens right before Jesus's death. And since Easter is just next Sunday, we wanted to show you guys this week. Let's watch it.
Stories of the Bible, The Last Supper. This is Jesus.
Heyo!
Who is the Son of God and the Savior of the world. While Jesus was on earth, he taught everyone about God's love and healed people from their sickness. He did many miracles like calming storms and even raised people from the dead.
Wahoo!
At this time, the Jewish people were celebrating a festival called Passover that had been celebrated since the time of Moses, when God brought his people out of Egypt. So Jesus was going to Jerusalem to celebrate. The disciples asked Jesus where he wanted to eat the Passover meal that night. Jesus said, "As you go into the city, a man carrying a pitcher of water will meet you.
Hello.
Follow him. At the house he enters, say to the owner,
hi.
The teacher asks, where is the guest room where I can eat the Passover meal with my disciples? He will take you upstairs to a large room that is already set up. That is where you should prepare our meal. The disciples found everything to be just as Jesus had said. Later that evening, Jesus arrived with the 12 disciples. They sat down to eat, and Jesus said that he was happy to be with everyone. As they were eating, Jesus took some bread and blessed it. He said, "Take it, for this is my body, which is given for you." Jesus told them to do this to help remember him. Then he took a cup of wine and gave thanks to God for it. And he said to his disciples, "This is my blood. It is poured out as a sacrifice to forgive the sins of many. Jesus said, "One of you eating with me here will betray me." He told them that things were supposed to happen this way, but that great sadness would await the one who betrays him. The disciples were very upset and asked, "Am I the one? Who is he talking about?" Judas asked Jesus, "Am I the one?" And Jesus said, "You have said it." One of the disciples asked Jesus, "Lord, who is it?" Jesus said it was the one who he would give the bread to. He gave the bread to Judas, and Jesus said, "Hurry and do what you're going to do." None of the others at the table knew what Jesus meant, so Judas left at once to betray Jesus. Then Jesus comforted and encouraged the disciples. He promised them that they would have a helper come when Jesus was gone. They all sang a song to God together.
Jesus and his disciples got together to eat the Passover meal, which was a time to celebrate and remember how God had saved his people in the past. But this Passover meal signified so much more than the disciples even realized. At this meal, he talked to them about his death and resurrection. He took some bread and he broke it and he said, "This is my body. Do this in remembrance of me." And then he took a cup of wine and he said, "This is my blood. Do this in remembrance of me." He gave them a symbol to remember him by, and we have that symbol today that we can remember Jesus's death and resurrection and how much he loves us and that our sins are forgiven. And this symbol we often call communion. You could talk to your parents about maybe reenacting how Jesus entered Jerusalem and the people had palm branches and put their coats down on the ground. Or maybe as a family, you could have a meal just like Jesus did with the disciples. Or even take communion together this week. I'm praying that this is a special week of celebrating and remembering what Jesus did for us on the cross. Let's pray right now together and thank him for what he has done. Jesus, thank you so much for taking our punishment and dying on the cross for our sins. We love you and we pray that we would remember what you did for us this week. In Jesus' name, amen. We'll see you guys next week.